Will that be enough to, of course, exonerate or to acquit the Chief Justice if this case is elevated to the Senate? Because going by the lessons of the 2012 impeachment trial of the former Chief Justice Renato Corona, he also assembled a powerhouse defense team. Superstars in their own rights, very much well known in the legal circle.
Well, this much I will tell you, Christian, no? Will it be enough? Well, I believe that Attorney Alex Poblador will certainly put up the best fight that he can. You know, Christian, it has been remarked several times that yes, we do concede that this is a political exercise, no? Well, even the Supreme Court, in that case of Gutierrez versus House of Representatives, had characterized it as such. Yeah. But you have to understand that, well, she is Chief Justice. There is some dignity attached to the office, no? She is, in a sense, also the chief lawyer. So the message, initially, that we would want to send to our countrymen is this. She has to proceed in accordance with what is specified in our Constitution. Mm. You know, our Constitution, despite perceptions to the contrary, it is alive. It should be kept alive. Its provisions should be embraced. Its procedures, its processes should be respected. Mm. And that is our intention here in these proceedings, no? To send this message to our countrymen that we shall abide by the processes. Mm. Many have said that we should be concerned about the political repercussions or the political motivations here. But we cannot do that, no? Yeah. The Constitution provides that it shall be our friends in the Congress who shall be stand as judges in these proceedings.
The senators in particular.
Well, initially, by way of, I don't know if the analogy is correct, but as preliminary investigators, the Committee on Justice and eventually the members of the House of Representatives, we have to acknowledge that they are the judges here. They are not the opponents. Mm. Our opponent, essentially, is not even Attorney Gadon. Our opponent, Christian, is the allegations that have been specified in Attorney Gadon in his impeachment complaint.
But sadly speaking, at the end of the day, this is still all about numbers. If they have the numbers, they may not necessarily need to prove the guilt of a person accused beyond reasonable doubt.
I do understand, and this is our perspective in that regard, Christian. No? Yes, they may have the numbers, but I think they would realize in the ultimate analysis that they are there and they have the numbers because they were elected to their offices. Mm. Now, who elected them? Well, there is this now apparently obscure provision in the Constitution which declares that sovereignty resides in the people and all governmental authority emanates from them. Well, this is what we are doing. This is the extent of the political thing that we shall be doing. We try to reach out to our countrymen, make them understand about the constitutional process. If they have sentiments about this particular impeachment proceeding, one way or the other, no? We implore upon our countrymen to kindly please get in touch with the representatives and make their hearts felt. We cannot treat the members of the House of Representatives as enemies here, no? Yeah. They can be friends, and we are hopeful that that would be possible. We are hopeful that our countrymen will reach out to them, have their basic conversations, and guide them. Mm. Now provide them with the proper course in this regard.
I think that's a very important lesson that was also learned during the 2012 impeachment trial. Your audience here is not just the senator judges eventually, or the members of the lower house, but of course the people. But also in that respect, people take that this might also turn into a public spectacle. Now, in that regard, for example, they say that it was a very crucial mistake committed by the former Chief Justice Renato Corona when he testified before the Senate impeachment trial. It's too early to ask whether the Chief Justice now would testify, but learning from that particular experience, what lesson can you draw out from there?
Well, the lesson perhaps would be that the Chief Justice, or the present Chief Justice, Chief Justice Sereno, would have to proceed very cautiously and determine her move as the events unfold. And she would certainly need to benefit from the advice of counsel, and I'm confident that Attorney Poblador would be able to provide her with the right counsel in this regard.
So far, what's the thought process of the Chief Justice now? Because she's been getting a lot of criticism, not just from the members of the House leaders themselves, who eventually would decide whether this case is elevated to the Senate, and of course, even coming from the President.
I will answer you on the basis of my very brief meeting with her, no? She struck me as a very courageous lady. No? She struck me as a lady who understands her duties being the Chief Justice of this Honorable Supreme Court of ours. No? Her perspective is, of course, there is some concern. Of course, she is worried. She cannot hide that. But the point is, she is determined to proceed in accordance with what is expected of her. She is determined, Christian, to maintain the dignity of the office which she occupies.
So resignation is not an option at this
Never
point?
Never an option. You know, we discussed that very briefly, but she said, you know, Caloy, I have to do this not for May Lou Sereno. I have to do this because of the importance of the office of the Chief Justice. I have to do this. I have to stand up more than anyone else for the independence of our judiciary, but, as personified best by our Supreme Court.
But is Sir Camp getting some messages or communication from, let's say, Malacanang or other groups somehow telling her, just resign?
Well, I have not really spoken with the Chief Justice in this regard, but I suppose the media reports to this effect, they have probably reached her already. We have done nothing by way of reiteration of what we had originally spoken of. Now that there would be no consideration at all of the matter of resignation, because the primordial thing here is that she is determined precisely to pursue those objectives of preserving the dignity of the office of the Chief Justice and the independence of the court.
Now, would you also concede that the Chief Justice at present is not that popular within her own court, within the judiciary, which somehow helps explain the cooperation of some members of the judiciary with the complainant and the House now?
Well, these are interpersonal matters, no? And you know, no one is perfect in terms of dealings, no? Personal dealings with people. But this much I should stress, I should emphasize in this brief interview, the Chief Justice is professional. She is a professional. Just like all the other magistrates in the Supreme Court, I have the highest respect, I have the highest admiration for these brethren of our Chief Justice, and we had a chance to briefly speak on this. She made it clear to me, whatever the interpersonal difficulties they may be experiencing, you know, they have proceeded with their work.
But do you think that's a big factor, the intramurals within the Supreme Court?
It may be, it may be not, we do not know. But may I share a brief anecdote with you, sure. Christian? No? You know, when my father, Justice Isagani A. Cruz, was in the Supreme Court, in one en banc meeting that they had, no, my father disclosed this to me. He had quite an argument with the venerable, very erudite Justice Feliciano. Mm. Their voices were at elevated levels, no, which is why this prompted the Chief Justice then, Chief Justice Tihanki, to suspend the proceedings. So they left, no, possibly in a huff, with a huff and a puff. But as soon as my father sat behind this desk in his office, he got a call from Justice Feliciano. Justice Feliciano said, Gani, I'm just reminding you, please, no, we have a dinner with Sally and Viring tonight. And my father responded, oh yes, Sally is on her way. Okay. You see my point, Christian, no?
Yeah.
There may be debates, there may be disagreements, discussions, there may even be elevated voices. Mm. But you know, these magistrates of ours in our Supreme Court, after everything's been said and done, they are brethren, okay. No? They are friends.